Part of the rules of engagement was that each journalist carries a pair of gumboots, and at first, many journalists did not understand the core importance of the safety wear until the field trip started. The reality of how important gumboots were came into realization upon arrival at the Operation Shujaa Sector 4 Tactical Headquarters at Luna in Ituri Province. It was all muddy and soggy ground with military equipment planted all around the sector headquarters. The journalists shared the experience while in the jungle and the importance of the footwear.
It's time to put on gumboots in my lifetime. I've been seeing them with farmers. I'm not a farmer myself, I'm a journalist, and I've been covering events in urban centers and all this, but now gumboots here becomes extremely very necessary because you block you keep yourself healthy, not only that, cleanliness. Yeah, and inconveniences, and easy to walk with. In gumboots here,
those things I actually thought would come through. But look here, you're in the jungle, and if you're going out in the jungle, you need a pair of gumboots, and that indeed is one of your top requirements while coming in this. It's muddy all over. Your soft shoes wouldn't do you any good at all. And I believe where we are going further, the rain may have poured through the night or even the days before. So it definitely is, it's indeed laughable, but you need gumboots.
While on a field trip in the jungles of eastern Congo, the journalists encountered a number of challenges, including the slippery ground and terrain, as they explain.
The importance of this gumboot here, minus advise it is a requirement. Without it, no one.
So that if you don't have gumboots here, you will not move, because everyone knows that Congo is covered with forest everywhere, and the roads, first of all, are impossible.
So everywhere it is muddy. The only thing to put on, actually, it's a gumboot. That's when you will have life.
ADF began activities in Uganda but was forced into the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo, where it is based. It carries out deadly attacks in villages near the borders and is accused of killing thousands of people in both countries since pledging allegiance to the Islamic States in 2019. The joint ground and air operation by Uganda and Congo were set up in 2021, and since then, at least 550 militias have been killed. Report by Roger Sandy for the news.